Hi, I'm Whelan Barzey from the British Blacklist, and today we're joined by Jonathan Majors, savant of the skincare routine, wearer of the red beanie hat. Where else do I go from this? GQ cover star, and now Nat Love in the Heart of the Fool. So how's London been treating you?
Well, a lot better now. I appreciate that.
A bit of work on the intro, as you can see.
It's pretty good.
Thank you so much, man. Would you be able to tell us a bit about Nat Love, who he is, what his intentions are? I'll leave that to you, as I'm not allowed to spoil the film. So.
Fair enough. Nat Love is, I won't spoil it either. Nat Love is an individual bent on a path of revenge, maybe redemption, because of a violation that happened to him when he was a very young person. He leads a gang. He's got a group of sharpshooters and bank robbers and killers. And the squad of them make their way through the West, surviving and thriving and loving. But ultimately, that love is out to get even.
Thank you. I felt like I knew you'd be able to sum that up much better than I have, and you've definitely proven the case.
That's funny.
What I was going to say is, how did you channel your own experiences of change and how that can change you as a person, your own intentions, when bringing it to this role? Because I can definitely see there's some parallels.
Well, I think there's a certain amount. I mean, the word violation is such a strong word, isn't it? But we all, in some way, have felt that. You know I have, and there's a certain amount of shame that comes with it. There's a certain amount of emptiness that we all have, whether we want to admit it or not. And I think people are separated into two different groups, those who accept that emptiness and then those who do something about it. And I, in my life, have tried to do something about it at every turn. And then a role like Nat Love comes, where he's hell-bent on doing something about it by any means necessary. And because of the hurt that he experienced, he has vulnerability. Mm-hmm. And so it makes him very full. And he needs love. He needs his buddies, you know. But he's got to get what he's got to get, because he's got to be made whole. I understand that. You know, I think everybody does. I don't think I'm separate in that. Mm-hmm. I think I'm just the one saying it right now.
Mm-hmm. Most definitely something that I could also relate to as well, like you said, in a moment of vulnerability. What I wanted to also ask you is that when you did Lovecraft Country, you referred to, I guess, how the Jim Crow era, in a sense, is also entwined in DNA. But I feel like this freedom and liberation and lawlessness is also intertwined within our DNA. Mm. And how good does it feel to be able to put that part of our DNA and that part of our heritage and lineage on screen?
Wow, bro. Hey, man, I think there is something. I mean, we broke chains and we're here now, you know. That is the spirit of the outlaw. That Nat Turner, that breakaway, that you can't hold me down, that I'm gonna be free, I'm gonna find that fresh air, I'm gonna build my own life, I'm gonna make it right for me and mine. That is Nat Love. You mm-hmm. know, that is the aggressive, the violent dismissal of oppression is Nat Love. You know, and that is freedom. Like, that is liberty, you know, and also the responsibility of that, taking that burden on, you know, that the freedom he has is heavy, but it's his, you know, and he's not going to give that up. And that's what the violation does. You put me in chains again. Mm-hmm. Now I've got to handle this to free myself, to get back to that redemption, to get back to that freedom. You really hit something there, man. I appreciate that.
Thank you. It was a question that I generally wanted to know the answer to. I'm glad that our listeners and viewers will be able to, but something that I personally connected with when I saw the freedom and liberation of you guys on horsebacks and just patrolling and just basically feeling as if like you own the land that you laid feet on. Yeah,
that's right.
The land that you helped build, in fact. So
that's right.
I definitely wanted to get your insight into that.
Yeah.
And I know that it wasn't just you as a solo individual, but it was an ensemble cast.
Yep.
What was it like having that experience shared amongst all of these different greats? I guess sharing maybe not a room, but this space.
Well, it's very similar to what we're doing now. Mm-hmm. It's like you feel like you and I are on one accord. Mm-hmm. You know, we're in this quiet agreement right now. I can feel it. You know what I mean? Like, you and I could go rob a bank right now, and we work it out. I just feel like we could pull it off, and that was the vibration between the whole cast, that we had all come to this place, we'd all come to this ground to do this, to tell this story, and there was a certain amount of commitment and a certain amount of vulnerability, and therefore a certain amount of energy that we were all putting into it. And there was no way, like even now, there's no way if you rob that bank, I'm gonna let you fail. No, you're gonna let me fail. There was no way we were gonna let either of us quit, slack, you know, not succeed, mm-hmm. you know, winning and making art was mm-hmm. the only option, you know, and we'll see what the folks think about it. But that was the objective, and that was the support from Idris, from Regina, from Lakeith, you can name no cast, you know, mm-hmm. but from those people, from Zazie Beatz, that was the feeling, you know, and as Nat, it felt, you know, it felt like support, you know, to lead a cast like that could feel, what are you going to mm-hmm. do? But that's the cheat sheet, you know, pressure is the same as support. It just depends on how you look at it. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Which way you're turning. Mm-hmm. Turn your back to it and it's pushing you forward. Mm-hmm. Turn your front to it and it's pushing you down. Amen. You know, so, yeah. Yeah.
No, I was going to say, in regards to the bank robbery, as long as you don't wear the red hat, we probably won't get caught.
You're right. Like, well, maybe they think I'm the guy from Candyman.
That too.
Yeah, that too.
I'm saying too much.
It's too deep.
And given your Texan roots, and I wanted to know, is this going to be the beginning of you in a series of Western films, or can we put a pin in it now? Do you feel like you've accomplished something and you've, I guess, lived a certain life now?
Well, there's a finite amount, as it stands right now, of mm-hmm. genres that, you know, films can be made in, you know, and the Western is one of them. And, you know, I never put limitations on, you know, what I'll do. You know, I don't want to repeat myself, you know, in any way, at any time, you know, so I keep an eye out for that. But the Western world and the Harder They Fall world is vast, you know, and of course, you know, I'd have to be invited, you know, to do something in that world again, the Western world. But no, I'd love to, you know, it feels like home.
That's just the answer that I wanted to hear, because I enjoyed seeing you in this, and I would love to see you in more different roles in this same world. So thank you so much for giving us this piece, and we hope to build up more pieces of the puzzle that is just for ages. Thank you so much.
Brother, appreciate
pleasure,
it.
Brother. Yeah?
Yeah.
Until next time. Yeah.
Open it.
Proof is a buck.
Man, old devil, this gonna be Buck's last day amongst the living.
What exactly he do to you?
Call it a professional robbery.
I know who you are. Nat Love, outlaw, hunts down those who trespass against him with no mercy.
Where is he?
Where is who?
Your boss.
My boss. Clearly, you don't know me.
I heard Rufus Buck was back.
This ain't no road to ask a friend to travel.
You think destiny's coming to you? My guns go bad. A new day is dawning.
Slow. Crosses on the head of an angel. Sins of the father, dumping drugs about to hand you. Faithful to the end. Bullets with your names drew. Cock back, aim, shoot, bang. I don't particularly enjoy violence. That being said, you are currently in company of extremely violent individuals.
Jump, mother. My guns gon' bang.
She ain't gonna end well for you.
Really?